Shake your money maker like somebody about to pay ya. I see you on my radar, don't you act like you afraid of shit.
You know I got it, if you wanna come get it, stand next to this money like, hey, hey, hey.
Shake your money maker like somebody about to pay ya. Don't worry about them haters, keep your nose up in the air.
You know I got it, if you wanna come get it, stand next to this money like, hey, hey.
Welcome to Book Time with Ryan. I am Ryan, and today we'll be talking about Kleptopia by Tom Burgis. This is how dirty money is conquering the world. I saw Tom Burgis on the news. I already had the book. I had had the book for months. But once I saw him on the news and the reminder that he wrote Kleptopia, I decided it was time to read it. So I finished the book I was reading. I got this one out. I read it. I really enjoyed it. Tom Burgis is an investigative correspondent with the Financial Times or the FT. A lot of this book is more focused on the enforcement, regulatory side of the United Kingdom, through the Financial Conduct Authority and the Serious Fraud Office, which is an angle or an approach that I haven't typically read. So that was nice. Most of the wrongdoing is taking place through shell companies and individuals who are from Russia and who are associated with Kazakhstan. A lot of the dirty money market really picked up with the fall of the Soviet Union and kind of the oligarchs and the kleptocracy that popped out through many of the fallen Soviet states. That's what this book is about. I thought it was really interesting. I've talked about this in other videos, that there are business, economics, and finance books that read like thrillers. And this book was one of those kinds of books. There is a spy thriller angle to this book. There's a lot of KGB or FSB, CIA, MI6 angles. This is about dirty money that needs to be laundered, and it goes around the world to be laundered, basically trying to erase the past of the money. So if the money was somehow gathered in an illegal way, drugs, human trafficking, weapons trafficking, the individuals that earn it have to figure out a way to erase the past of this money, to somehow make it look clean, to launder the money. But how do you do that? It talks about how these are such large amounts that it's not an easy, especially if they're paid in cash and they're paid in small bills, it's really hard to cycle through that in a way that almost makes it like new cash. So this book really follows, I think, mostly a group of people from Kazakhstan who, after the fall of the Soviet Union, fell in the good graces of the Kazakh president at the time. Through that support, and this Kazakh president really saw everything as either you're with me or you're my enemy. Through that support, they made out very nicely, billions of dollars. Now, these individuals had the problem of, how do you clean this money that's associated with this dictator in Kazakhstan, that's associated with banks that have KGB backing in Russia? How do you launder the money? And the answer, in large part, was moving money through different shell companies. Different obscure companies that are located in pretty opaque countries like the Bahamas, the Seychelles, some of the states in the UK like Guernsey or the Isle of Man. There's a way to move money around, also to avoid taxes or to try to avoid taxes, to kind of create false transactions between these companies that are actually related to each other, but they're opaque, so the outside world doesn't know that they have the same directors or the same individuals that are really just have signing authority, that maintain bearer bonds that allow them to show through the bearer bonds that once they bear those bonds, they control the company. You also see that a lot of the process is through real estate, especially paying cash. So you'll look at transactions that involve all of these very expensive estates that are purchased for millions of dollars above the listing price. And that's really just to try to funnel money through those pieces of property to take the money out at some point as clean money. Now that you've purchased it with the dirty cash, once you sell or take out mortgages or whatever you want to do with that property, the money you're getting back from it is clean, because it's coming from a legitimate source. A lot of this book deals with a group of men called the Trio that had a company in Kazakhstan. Basically, the dirty things they did and the shifting relationship they had with other Kazakhs around them, the official government. They listed a company on the London Stock Exchange and then had a lot of trouble later on. They raised money from the public and then they took the money out and kind of raided it as individuals. According to this book, it really talks about that, how these individuals benefited from this process and how they benefit and how the dark market, the dark money, touches the legitimate side of business too, through energy companies, precious metal mining, diamond mines in Africa, oil and natural gas in Russia. Basically, the approach that corrupt states, kleptocracies with oligarchs, we're thinking Russia, Putin specifically, the approach that these countries take to essentially rob their people and amass fortunes in a small group, into a select group of hands, the oligarchs, the kleptocrats. So that's what this book is about. I enjoyed it. The first, I'd say, three quarters of the book is really European-based and Asian-based and African-based. And I'd say the final quarter of the book really shifts the focus across the Atlantic to the United States. It works basically from the financial crisis through 2020, when the book was published. There are periods of the book that go further back, just to give a little bit of detail. The hardest thing I had with this book is the names. There are a lot of Kazakh names, there are a lot of Russian names, and these names, to me, look so similar. They're Avs and Evs. They're very long, and it was hard for me to keep track of some of the more obscure names because they didn't look that different, and I wasn't selling them out because I didn't even know where to start. So that was the only kind of drawback I thought, just, and it's me, right? Because I'm sure other people don't have problems with names, but it was hard for me to keep track of some of the names until they had been repeated multiple times throughout the book and turned into major parts of the book. I liked it a lot. For me, as an American, it was interesting to read about the Serious Fraud Office and the Financial Conduct Authority in the UK. It was very timely, even though this book is a couple years old now. Just with what the Russians are doing in Ukraine, killing innocent people in an illegal war, an invasion. It's interesting to read about how individuals like Putin are funded and how they rob their own people blind. So I really enjoyed it. I recommend it. I give it 4 stars, which is good. Tom Burgis, Kleptopia, How Dirty Money is Conquering the World. Check it out. It's timely. It's relevant. And it really applies to all the corners of the world, except maybe Antarctica, everywhere else. So check it out. I think you'll enjoy it. And thanks for joining me today.
Your money maker like somebody about to pay ya. I see you on my radar, don't you act like you were afraid of me.
You know I got it, if you wanna come get it, stand next to this money like, hey, hey, hey.
Your money maker like somebody about to pay ya. Don't worry about them haters, keep your nose up in the air.
You know I got it, if you wanna come get it, stand next to this money like, hey, hey.